It's really this week where all the records that we've had in big quantities have come in, and when they've come in, you know, the day starts with a good amount of effing and blinding from the delivery drivers, and then we've got hundreds, literally hundreds of some releases. There's so much really good stuff here, but just the actual amount of man hours it's taking to kind of display it and to get it to the position where we can give it to the customers en masse. You know, the people that are here now, like Dave and Adam, they're both working here because they care about it and they want it to be as good as they can tomorrow. It's not just caring about music and releases. It's caring about the shop and what this shop can do for music in the wider community. And this job is so much fun, but it's a lot of work. And you know, we finished last night at 3:30 or so, and then start again at 10 o'clock the next day, and we're kind of working through now until we finish, and then we need to be here at 8 o'clock for to watch the crowds in the morning. So it's a lot of work, but I'm fully aware that anyone watching this, like so many people are kind of would love to work here, and the you know, we're very lucky to have this job, and we don't take that for granted. So I sound like I'm moaning now, and I probably am a little bit, but it's still something we're doing out of a love and desire to do so. No one's making us do this. 5 to 10, 200 people queuing. I think we're just about there. Welcome to Banquet's record store day for 2011. It's been pretty hectic this morning, about 300 people queuing from 4 a.m. onwards. Yeah, I mean, record store day for us is, I mean, obviously a celebration of vinyl and CD, like the stuff we kind of, build our lives on. It's our livelihoods, but also it's not just this day that's a busy day for us. We have kind of a couple hundred shows a year, so it's almost another day for us in a busy year, but yeah, certainly the one which brings out the most kind of punters. All our regulars are here, good to see a lot of familiar faces as well as a few faces from the past.
After the BDI box set, it's only going to be available in America, so I was a bit surprised they got it here as well. So
7 o'clock.
But we left at 4.
The installs and the gigs, to be honest, really good value, and good to see like a band twice in an evening sort of thing.
This year it's been Alpines. I thought they were brilliant, but no, overall the answering machine was pretty awesome.
I've done a lot of mail order with Banquet before, because we tend to sort of have a few things when nobody else has.
I read an interview in the NME by some tall sort of gunning record store day and the effects of record shops and stuff like that. It's my local, I'm in here every day, and I just thought, you know, get up early, come down and do your bit really, stand in the queue with some people that love records.
We've spoken a lot about the importance of record store day, about getting people into the store who haven't been here before or don't come here much. But I think one of the really important things of record store day is a lot of our customers will come in here and they're coming in tomorrow to pick up maybe this piebald record, which is exclusive to us in the UK, and then they look around and they'll see some other stuff that they wanted to get for a few weeks, and they might buy that too. They might pick up a gig ticket for some of the shows we're doing. And it's really important that Record Store Day is about those exclusive releases, but it's also about celebrating the store and what the store can do. Not just about a one-off day. It's about you know, what we do throughout the year.